This morning for Heart of the Basin, we have Casey Hallmark with CASA of the Permian Basin. Good morning, Casey.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me.
Of course. So first thing, can you tell us a little bit about CASA of the Permian Basin and what it does?
Yeah. So CASA stands for Court-Appointed Special Advocates, and we are just lay people who have a love for children, and we help kiddos in the foster care system.
Oh, okay. Definitely a great effort there. But how has the pandemic impacted CASA?
It's really impacted us by our volunteers. So we are a volunteer-driven organization. The more volunteers we have, the more kids we can serve. And with the pandemic, everybody having to stay inside, we're really having a hard time getting volunteers to come and volunteer with us.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I could definitely see how that would be tough. But what does it mean to be a CASA volunteer? What do people do when they volunteer? What are the requirements?
Yeah, so to be a volunteer, you must be 21. Okay. You have to pass background checks, and then you have to have a love for kids. So everybody asks, can I be a volunteer and have a job? You absolutely can. It takes about 10 hours a month.
Okay.
There's a training involved. I have one coming up this month, so they just need to reach out to me or check our website, and they'll get all the information.
Okay, perfect. And so what would the volunteers do on a daily basis after maybe they've had that training and gone through all the checks that you mentioned?
Yeah, so we work completely independently, so we don't work with CPS. We're not actual foster parents. We go and we do our own investigation about what's going to be best for these kids moving forward. So we meet with everybody, we advocate for them educationally, medically, all those things. We write a report to the judge and we tell the judge, this is what I feel is going to be best moving forward.
Okay, and you know, maybe some people think, hey, I'd love to help kids in the community, but you know, it sounds like it's going to be really tough emotionally. What would you say to people who are maybe having that as almost a reservation to volunteer?
I would say that Ector County has a huge amount of child abuse. At one point in time, we were number two in the state per capita, only behind Harris County. So child abuse is happening. It's up to us to stand up and give these kids a voice. So yes, it is hard, and we have days that we struggle, but majority of the time we have days where we're really championing these kids, and it's a very, very good experience for us, not only for us, but the kids. So it's well worth it.
And when is that volunteer sign-up or information session you said?
Yeah, so we have a training coming up this month, and then if they go on our Facebook page, I have all kinds of information. Our website has more information. They can call me. I would love, love, love for the community to step up and help these kids that need it.
And again, one last time, if you can give a plea for people to volunteer and why they should.
You should definitely volunteer with us. It's very rewarding for you, but we're really helping kids. You can change their life. You're advocating for them not only in the worst time of their life, but you're really helping them get through and be their voice in court. So it's very important that we represent our kiddos.
Great. Thank you so much for joining us, Casey, and telling us more about your organization.
Thank you for having me.